Good morning, friends. Now I am going to discuss about some common finfish diseases and their control measures. The diseases of fish in culture system, pond culture system, mainly arises due to the imbalance of the three factors, mainly host, these are the fish, pathogens, and the environment. And we can control this by water quality and nutritional management, quarantine of new animals, and sanitation. What are the symptoms of sick fish? The main symptoms of sick fishes are change of normal behavior, pale color of gills and skin, asymmetrical growth, then loss of appetite, presence of lesions or sores, reduced vitality, etc. Amongst the common diseases, one of the most common diseases, that is EUS, episodic ulcerative syndrome. And the disease, mainly the lesions or spots on the surface, and after that the ulcer can go up to the internal organs. It occurs due to the low temperature, polluted water, or by the fungus, that is the aphanomyces invadens. We can treat by using lime, salt, or mixture of lime and liquid green turmeric or dust of turmeric. Cefax 1.66 liter for per 1 hectare area is also can be used. KMNO4 is also good for management of these EUS diseases. Next one, white mold or cotton wool. That is main symptom is that cotton or thread-like tufts may arise from the body or the mouth. Main reason is the rough handling, loss of mucus, and fungi, that is the saprolegnia species, or high organic load. We can treat with malachite green bath, formalin, or copper sulfate. Gill rot, the main fungus is the brachiomyces species. Gill filaments becomes reddish and subsequently fade and causes of gill rot. Reasons that decaying organic matter, we can treat by a deep treatment in 5 mg per liter water KMNO4 solution, or stopping artificial feeding, or apply quick lime. Next one, that is the fin or tail rot. Here also loss of natural color, fin rays becomes bristle and start breaking. The reasons are high organic load, poor water quality, and the bacteria, Aeromonas or Pseudomonas species. The treatment is mainly by painting the affected parts by CuSO4 or KMNO4 betadine, or H2O2 can be used, and affected parts can be clipped off. Chloromycetin and tetramycin also can be used for this. Dropsy, that is also one common disease of the amongst the fishes. That in that case, the sudden swelling or the bacterial infection also will cause the internal bleeding. And in case of chronic swelling, growing tumors or even parasites in the fish may cause it to swell. Reasons are high organic load, poor pond condition, and the bacteria Aeromonas species. Kidney sometimes will be dysfunction. Treatment, it is not curable disease, but sometimes we can use salt bath or tetracycline or chloromycetin can be used. Ulcer disease, that is the ulcer from the first that pimple-like projections, and that it can be transformed into ulcer, which can go up to the internal organ. That is also due to by high organic load and the bacteria, mainly the Haemophilus aeruginosa species. Treatment mainly can be done by the KMnO4, oxytetracycline, or you can destroy the badly affected fish. Next one, that is the reddish blotch disease. The posterior part of the body exhibiting reddish and oozing blood and formation of clots. That is also due to high stocking density, high organic load, and mainly due to the bacteria. You can take that in case of treatment, you can reduce the stocking density and the pond treatment by KMnO4 or oxytetracycline. Next one, that is the eye disease. In that case, the cornea of eyes turns vascular and letters can epoch, and also the eyeball becomes decay or lost vision. The pollution and the aeruginosa and staphylococcus are the main reason. You can use the chloromycetin and the pond treatment by KMnO4. Next one, the white spot disease. There you can see that the white grain or salt like structure around the body, the fishes will move erratically, and they will scratch against the objects there. The main reasons are the pollution of water and ectoparasites, and it can be spread through the other fishes also, infected fishes also. In case of treatment, you can use the common salt solution or betadine, or you can use the disinfectant like salt or quicklime. You can follow the quarantine method, and if possible, you can increase the water temperature from 70 degree to 80 degree Fahrenheit. Next one, that is the white gill or scale spot disease. Gill becomes whitish first, and then fish will come out through the surface for gulping air. And the in acute cases, seeds look like a cauliflower shape on the gill. Reasons are high organic load and ectoparasites, myxozoa. In case of treatment, you can reduce the stocking density, bathing by common salt, and disinfectant by quicklime or salt, or you can destroy or burn the infected fishes. Next one, that is the anchor worm. That is the hook-like anchors. They will attach to the body of the fish, and they will lose their weight and stunted growth, red spots at the site of infection. Reason, that is the high organic load and the ectoparasite crustacea Leronia species, contaminated water and some other aquatic plants also behind the disease. Treatment by using common salt solution, cypermethrin or glacial acetic acid, or you can treat the pond water with KMnO4. Next one, fluke. That is the gill, eye or skin. They can attack on these, and the fishes becomes restless, and they will rub their body against the substrate, and the attack of the fluke on the body or gills of the fish, they will gasping for air. The main reason, that is the leech or leech-like animals, that is the gyrodactylus or dactylogyrus. High stocking density also there. You can use the deep treatment by formalin or acetic acid, or by common salt, or you can destroy the disinfected fishes. Black spot disease. Black spot appears throughout the body, then skin and the muscles and the surface of the body. You can see that the fin also sometimes comes black, and that is due to by diagenetic flukes, diplostomum species, or diplostomum, mainly the diplostomum species also the causative agent, that is, or due to the polluted water it can spread. You can remove the molluscan species, or deep treatment through the picric acid can be treated. So these are the common diseases of fishes, but it is always said that prevention is better than cure. So there are some other diseases also caused due to the nutritional and environmental disorders, and some other factors also can be treated as causes for the fish diseases. But for a farmer or aquaculturist, it is better to take the prevention. So it is always said that prevention is better than cure. So for proper water quality management, if you follow that, then it can be controlled or managed properly. Thank you for your listening.